referees for tonight's game, Tom Chmielewski and Garrett Rank. The linesmen are Jesse Marquis and Ryan Galloway. Do not adjust your set. It is not in black and white tonight.
This is a player that, you know, looked out of sorts, John. Like he didn't belong the first month of the regular season, but boy, he has really started to settle in.
And here he is cutting to the slot. He hands it off and they score! The redirect at the near post from Kajula. It's 1-0 Chicago. Let's look at play as Doc gained the zone to begin things.
It's the defenseman Boquist that makes this happen. That is a real heads-up shot pass from him. Kajula drives to the far post. Boquist spots him.
He backhands it around the boards. The Ducks captain has it again. Into the middle. Hyman has time off his skate to his stick. And Crawford got a piece of it. Irwin steps up, tees it up, and a lively rebound that Keith wands away as Henrique was sneaking from behind. Here's Kane. Down the slot for Strome, and a save by Gibson.
Oh, great stop. That is another great blocker save from John Gibson.
Nylander keeps it alive, and the Hawks work it around the perimeter. Into the middle, Murphy. Nylander picks it up off the post. Pops in the air, and then rolls away from Patrick Kane.
And then Nylander tries to beat Gibson again. Previous general manager was probably fired because
yeah,
of
because
Kevin.
Of the trade to acquire Kevin Fiala. You're right, he's their leading scorer. Here's a point-blank chance for Milano, and Crawford, who is really on his game tonight, just expunges that opportunity.
It's especially true in these second periods because it's a tougher change.
Oh, nice redirect by Saad, and Gibson with his best save of the game. Puck just rifled off the boards, and now he reaches out and gloves off the bid from Boquist. He completes the pass, and Kane works it to the line. Duncan Keith with Boquist out high, skates around Milano to the high slot. He hit the post.
Boquist can fire the puck, can't he?
He's having a heck of a game.
He sure is.
Kane lays it back. Boquist across for Keith. Middle of the ice, Dylan Strome right back to Keith. Boy, the Hawks have got it on a string right now, just throwing it around the zone. Keith winds, fires, redirected, wide. And Strome scores.
And it's Strome who's there to mop it up. See him coming down the middle of your screen right now. Henrique went for the block. Unfortunately, didn't get it done. And that was an active bounce off the end boards that comes right to Strome. And he's got a wide open net to chip that over the right leg pad of John Gibson.
100th career point for Dylan Strome. Camp from out of the Chicago zone, carries it all the way to the Anaheim line, flips it in off the glove of Gouley, and he quickly moves it back. Milano speeds into the Hawk zone, goes wide, trying to get away from Connor Murphy. Into the slot, nice pass, and Juice with a great pass, and Hyman with an empty net makes it 2-1.
What a response, and what a great pass. Juice is going to join the play, slip down from the left point, and head up all the way, and Denton Hyman just kind of slides into a quiet area right in the middle. Look at Hyman kind of back up, make the stick available. Juice finds him.
So three newcomers combine on the goal. Christian Juice now finds Getzlaf. Silverberg comes over down low, Raquel right to the far post, and it's denied by Crawford.
Oh, stop.
A good opportunity for Henrique there. Hyman tried to step in with steel, kept for a moment at the line by Delzato, and here's a short-handed breakaway for Brandon Saad. Stick save, Gibson.
That's a big stop again by Gibson.
Double teamed up the boards, he fails, and here comes Ryan Carpenter shorthanded. Sneaks it through, Kajula, and another blocker save by Gibson.
Hand-eye coordination, but not legal. He knocks that puck down well above the height of his shoulders.
Irwin, a native of Victoria, British Columbia. Great pass by Kane, and Strome has his second of the game. The Hawks have reinstilled the two-goal cushion.
Kane, as he is so dangerous. Watch when he gets this puck. And he's just going to make one shift, get inside, and just zip that pass. You talk about time and space. It's a little bit too much time and space for Patrick Kane. When you give him that much time in the offensive zone, he can make things happen. You'd like to see the defenseman step on.
He's in on Crawford, and he's hooked by Boquist, losing the puck. No call. Led back the other way. It's a two-on-one. Nylander has Taves with him. Nylander goes backhand and scores.
And then the puck turns over, and look at all the time for Nylander.
You talked about how quick his hands are earlier in the telecast, Brian.
Well, Jacob Larsson does the right play, and he has to play the pass there. And you got to leave Nylander to your goaltender, John Gibson, but that's a high-skilled player. Because he's got so much time, he's allowed to adjust his speed and move in even slower, which makes it so much more difficult for Gibson.
Ninth of the season for the former Mississauga Ice Dog. He's got it again, and they score! This time he sets up Kane.
A breakdown in the defensive zone. Puck's going to get away from Irwin. And this time Larsson does not do the job of tying up the stick away from the puck.
Nylander comes up with the puck in the Anaheim zone. And Mata's shot off a couple of sticks in the feet of Brendan Gulley. And a couple of whacks at it for Kajula. And now Kane is checked hard into the end boards by Gulley. And Strome takes exception to that. Back to Keith. Two-man game between he and Kane now on the side of the net. They set up Taves and a save by Miller.
That's a good-looking pass.
David Camp tips it into the Anaheim zone. Fired in front and Highmore denied by Miller.
What a stop. Great stop by Ryan Miller.
51 points in 58 games for the Hawks after the trade last season. So he certainly paid instant dividends. Larsson's shot got through and redirected on the way. I think David Backes got a piece of it.
Let's have a look at it. Delorier is just going to get it back to the point. That shot's going on net, but it's Carter Rowney that gets a little tip on this puck. Tips it back against the grain.
For Larsson, the assist gives him 6 points in his last 13 games. We're seeing more offense from him.
Oh!
Here's Getzlaf on a rebound, and Crawford keeps it out. Getzlaf looks to the heavens. Miller having a little trouble with it. Now just able to nudge it away. Delzato lost it to DeBrincat, and Kajula turned away point blank by Miller. And this is Christian Juice to Raquel. Juice has it again, fakes the shot, walks all the way to the ladies' tees, and a save by Crawford. Down low, Getzlaf trying to sneak down for that seam pass from Steele, but it's knocked off his stick by Highmore, and then Getzlaf fans on it. Here comes Matthew Highmore, shorthanded. Pulls it to the backhand, and Miller grabs it off and hangs on.
Great stop by Ryan Miller.
Backes puts it in on the backhand. Keith is there. Hit by Rowney. He turned the puck over, and what a chance for Delorier. Getzlaf trying to get it off the wall. Dives, but Highmore wins the puck. Highmore down low for Camp. He scores! Well, that was just a great effort play by Matthew Highmore, and Camp with the finish.
Of this Chicago team, this is a good example of it. A one puck battle, and now it's like a 3-on-2 down low. But the pass from Highmore across the Camp is perfect. And the key here is that he zips it. It gets right underneath.
And Nylander takes it behind his own goal. Chicago playing keep away. The Ducks will let them as the clock extinguishes. And this one is complete tonight in Chicago. Corey Crawford was very good early.